It wasn't too long after I had read them the poem about hell. You should have seen the look on their faces, sweating, cramped together, shoulder to shoulder in that stuffy, dark room that I escaped by an exit door, lurching towards the side that opened up to a small adjacent courtyard, and I used a workman's abandoned stepladder to scale the 10-foot brick wall, hoisted my briefcase full of poetry up on the top course, and straddled a tightrope 6-inch rope path down to where a beat-up conversion van was parked, and lowered myself down to the ground, jumping down, hitting the ground squarely with a bounce. And I was free of that hot, freaking little edition of hell in there that I just got done reading to them about. And I jumped in my car and hit the highway and headed out of the city at dusk like my hair was on fire. I nailed the gas pedal up to 70 and all the windows were open and the muggy evening air whipped around me as a wild, deafening concussion of my wheels murdering that asphalt, roaring in my ears. Man, I felt good, strong. Escaping mediocrity will do that for you. Headlights shone in my rearview mirror. Retreating in the distance, I was leaving them all in the dust. And I hunched over the steering wheel on an angle towards the window like a World War II fighter pilot, thinking, I know what I had seen back there. I know what I had heard. And I had learned a very valuable lesson tonight. I can blow anyone away in the room, right out of the sky. And I intend to do just that for the rest of my life. That is, till somebody at last, someday, finally gets me.